Hey everybody, Emily here, and I'm your fancy pharmacist. Today, I wanted to do a video on the dreaded maskne. I've been waiting to do this video for a little while because I've actually been dealing with a bit of an outbreak. It's covered up pretty well right now, but I had like 3 huge spots of cystic acne, as well as some other breakouts due to having to wear a mask all day at work. And I have been trying a couple different regimens, and I think I finally have it. So I wanted to share that with you guys today to hopefully help you guys as well. Maskne, yes. Main thing, if you have to wear a cloth mask all the time, definitely wash it every other day, or have enough of them where you can wear a clean one every day. I work in healthcare as a pharmacist, as most of you know, so I am wearing a medical mask every day, and mask gets soiled, or if I've used it for too long, I just switch it out. So let's get started. I made a graphic that has my checklist for AM and PM. Now, when you look at that graphic, you're probably going to think to yourself, holy buckets, that is a lot of product. But the way I designed the checklist is so the products can kind of flow in and flow out based on what your needs are. So I want to kind of run through those things real quick for the AM and the PM to talk about them. If you need help picking out a maskne routine, we can totally do this over Messenger, or you can text me and we can figure out based on that list kind of what you're needing right now. Here we go. So in the morning, when I get up in the morning, this is what my typical routine is. I am always using my 3-in-1 cleanser. So I really love our 3-in-1 cleanser, because it's going to cleanse, it's going to balance, it's going to tone, it's going to nourish, and it's also going to hydrate. So we have 4 different types in our line. I use the dry. There's a normal to dry, a normal to oily, and an oily to acne line. So a little bit goes a super, super long way. So I'm cleansing my face every morning. After that, I am using our facial resurfacer. This used to come in a jar, and it's actually like volcanic ash. I like this stuff because it's like titanium, iron, calcium, and when you look at it underneath a microscope, it's actually a complete sphere. So as you're exfoliating your face, you're not going to cut your face like other scrubs that I might have used in the 90s. Psst, apricot scrub. So I don't know if you were a child of the 90s where I like basically like cut little, yeah, I cut my face with that stuff. Then you would put the moisturizer on and it would sting so bad. Oh. Okay. So anyway, I use this after I cleanse to kind of exfoliate. Exfoliation is really important for good skincare anyway, but especially with the maskne stuff going on, you're really gonna need to slough that dead skin off a whole area. All right, so then after I do these first steps, this is gonna be kind of the same thing at night too. This is where you can kind of have some options. So if I currently have a blemish, or if I feel like an underground zit coming on, if I currently have anything going on, I am going to put a little bit of our spot on treatment. This stuff is pretty awesome. So it is nearly a 10% benzoyl peroxide treatment. Now, in the past, I have not liked other benzoyl peroxide treatments because my skin is really dry. And what I find with the other ones that I have purchased at just like a regular drugstore is that it doesn't really help my acne spot. It just like dries my skin and kind of gives me almost a chemical burn. So honestly, I was kind of scared to start trying this stuff, but as the pharmacist in me has to dig through the ingredients. One of the things that makes this super different compared to the stuff that you can buy over the counter is it has what's called dimethyl isosorbide, okay? So why that's important, if you look from a pharmacy standpoint, isosorbide is a medication that we use for chest pain and blood pressure. And what isosorbide does is it vasodilates. So basically what this is doing, when you're putting this on an angry zit that's all red and irritated and inflamed, it's basically vasodilating the tissue so the benzoyl peroxide can actually go deeper down where the problem is and start clearing that blemish up versus just sitting on the top of your skin and making it more angry. So I really like this stuff. This is the stuff that in a tiny bit, like I use like the tiniest little drop just to put like right on the spot, okay? So this stuff is gonna be something that you may or may not use depending on what is currently going on, but like I feel like by the next day, my blemishes look better when I use the spot on treatment. I have some gals that do kind of put a coat of this all over their face. If their skin tends to be acne prone, that is okay too. So spot on would be next after that. Then what I do, this is normal in my routine, climate control, because this is like the mother of all anti-aging moisturizers. It's a sodium hyaluronate. It's gonna help keep the moisture and the hydration from leaving the skin, and it's going to just help all things anti-aging. I have a whole nother video devoted to climate control. If you wanna learn more, go ahead and search for that video, or if you need me, I can send you the link. It's awesome stuff. After the climate control, as you will learn in the climate control video, this stuff is such a small molecule, it has to be sealed. So my next step after that is using my daytime moisturizer. I just do one pump all over, okay? Now, again, this is where things can be different based on what your goals are and what you're doing for the day. One of the other recommendations with maskne is actually to take like a foundation break from your makeup. So all week when I was trying to clear these up, I basically just focused on like doing eye looks, left like all of this blank and did not put even my tinted moisturizer on it. Now, if you're going to need to wear foundation or something like that, steps then, I always do a little bit of eye illuminator. So this is nice if you're going to do a no makeup day or a makeup day, because it is like an eye cream, but it's something that you can wear during the day. And it's got our pearlizer in it. So if you're a person that kind of has some dark circles going on and you don't want to wear concealer for the day because you don't want it to come off on your mask, this is just gonna kind of just brighten up that eye area and give it a nice treatment, especially if your eye area is getting like rubbed raw from that mask sitting there. This is just gonna provide all sorts of nourishment underneath the eye. Okay, now if you're gonna go on to makeup, the next thing that a lot of people like to use is our Silk Pore Minimizer Primer. So that is really nice because it just makes the skin really even and it makes the foundation go on even better. You do not have to do that step, but I have some clients that are like swearing by that product that it's helping, like when the mask is like chafing, it's helping keep everything on. Okay, Silk could be a plus or minus depending on what your goals are and what you like to use. And then after that, you can either use our Color Corrected Tinted Moisturizer, is what my daily thing is, or our foundation. I will tell you that our tinted moisturizer is not gonna be as bulletproof as our foundation. Our foundation should not very much come up off on your mask at all. The tinted moisturizer, I find, will come off on my mask a little bit. So again, if I'm working and we're trying to conserve our masks without soiling them, I'm not doing a lot of makeup from basically here on down right now. I'm still doing some lips because this isn't coming off, but I'm just kind of leaving this blank. Okay, the other thing I do in the morning is I pop on our lip volumizer. I throw this on as I'm doing the rest of my skincare just to plump and hydrate those lips. When my lips are behind that mask, they are getting super dry. That is the other reason why I'm wearing lip scents a lot, because it's protecting my lips from that chafing if that mask is moving, and then I can put the clear gloss on and it soaks in and it's not transferring to my mask. So that is kind of what I've been doing in the morning, and it is like saving my face. Like I said, most of those things can be kind of a plus or minus depending on what your goals are. You just gotta let me know you need help with. Okay, Now for the nighttime routine. So a couple extra steps in here because I want my skin to repair overnight. The first thing, remove your makeup. If you wore any makeup for the day, make sure you are using a makeup remover to remove your makeup, because cleansers are not designed to remove makeup. They are designed to wash your face. That is step one, number one, and that is something that I am guilty of not doing from time to time because usually I work so much at night that I kind of like fall asleep with my makeup on and then I have to get up and hurry up and clean it all off. So don't be like me, okay? So again, we're gonna start with removing your makeup, cleanser, facial resurfacer, and then this is an extra step that I only do a couple nights a week because I'm still easing my skin into it. We have a new retinol product. So I've been putting retinol all over my face and really concentrating if I have blemishes because it really does help well with acne. Now, if you wanna learn more about retinol, I have two videos on retinol. I have a beginner's guide because there's a lot of stuff you need to know when you're starting a retinol treatment. And then I also have a full pharmacist review on this product. You can go find those videos, or if you need help, I will send you the link. So I've been putting all of this on after I cleanse and exfoliate. This is only happening like once or twice a week though, because you have to build retinol in, and my skin is not to the point where it can handle it every night. That is something that has been extremely helpful. And then of course I top that with my climate control, because the stuff I use twice a day, every day, no matter what, because it keeps everything lovely. This is hands down my favorite skincare product we have. Again, go check out the video. And then another thing I have been adding, if my blemishes are really angry, I've been putting a tiny, tiny bit of our Nangai oil on. So this is like a straight triglyceride fatty oil that comes from a Nangai nut. And it is great for like scars and burns and really anything that needs repair. Anti-inflammatory activity, and it's not like an oil that's going to make you break out more. Highly moisturizing, it smells really good, and like I only do like a drop and kind of just put it over where all that mask is being covered every day. Really like this stuff. So that's the Nangai oil. And again, this is not every night either. After the Nangai oil, I am doing my evening moisturizer. This is kind of normal of my routine. Throwing on some eye cream so I can help prevent those bags from underneath my eyes. Then I am putting our collagen night pack on. I don't have that down here with me, but that kind of seals everything in and it just provides more collagen production overnight, which is good for the skin. And then I am ending my skincare routine with our awesome liquid gold lip balm, just to keep adding the moisture to the lips. Take a look at the checklist. Let me know what questions you have. Those are the steps in and out that have been saving my skin with all of the maskne that's been going on. So I hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, give it a like, give it a share. If you're not in my VIP group, get in there and you'll even learn more. So like always, until next time, see you guys.